Hello everyone. Today I will be doing a revision of the chapter Principles of Inheritance and Variation. Let us first understand what is meant by inheritance. Inheritance is the process by which characters are passed from parents to the offsprings. It is the basis of heredity, whereas variation means different characters between the parents and your offsprings is known as variation. Let us look into some of the important terms which will be there in this chapter. First is genetics. Genetics means the study of heredity and variation, or the study of genes and chromosomes. Now, what is meant by heredity? Resemblance between offspring, that is the progenies, and their parents. What is meant by variation? That I have already said, difference between the parents and the offsprings. Inheritance. Inheritance means the transmission of characters from the parents to offsprings. What is meant by alleles? Allelomorphs, the alternate term of a gene. Some more important terms. First one, that is the dominant characters. The character which is expressed, it indicates with capital letters. Recessive character, the character which is suppressed, it indicates with small letters. Homozygous, the condition in which the chromosome pair carries similar alleles of a gene. Example, capital T, small t, capital Y, small y, etc. Next is the heterozygous, the condition in which the chromosome carries dissimilar alleles of a gene. Example, T, y, etc. Next one is genotype, that is visible character, physical expression of an individual. Genotype, genetic constitution of a character. Okay, let us learn some about the Gregor Johann Mendel, who is known as the father of genetics. He is known as the father of modern genetics. Gregor Mendel developed the principle of heredity while studying 7 pair of inherited characters, pea plants. Although the significance of his work was not recognized during his lifetime, it has become the basis for the present day field of genetics. How was Mendel's approach? He conducted hybridization, artificial pollination, or cross-pollination experiment for 7 years, that is from 1856 to 1863, and proposed the law of inheritance. Applied statistical analysis and mathematical logic for biology problems. Large sampling size, greater creditability to data. Experiments, true breeding, P lines, continuous self-pollination. Confirmation of inference from experiments on successive generations of test plants proved general rules of inheritance. Mendel investigated 2 opposite traits, that is the tall and dwarf, yellow and green seed. Why Mendel selected the pea plant? Because they are pure variety, are available. Pea plants are easy to cultivate. Life cycles of plants are only few months, so that the result can be got early. Contrasting trait are observed. Flowers are bisexual and normally self-pollinated. Flowers can be cross-pollinated only manually. Hybrids are fertile. Mendel's hybridization experiment. Mendel selected 7 pairs of true breeding garden pea varieties, that is the Pisum sativum. Steps in making a cross in pea. Selection of 2 pea plants with contrasting characters, removal of anthers, emasculation of 1 plant to avoid self-pollination, this is female parent. Collection of pollen grains from the anther plant, from the other plant, male parent, and transfer to the female parent, pollination. Collection and germination of seeds to produce offsprings. The 7 characters that were selected by Mendel. Characters, that is stem height, which is the dominant one, that is capital T, the dwarf one is small t. Flower color, capital V, small v. Flower position, axil, that is capital A, terminal, that is small a. Pod shape, that is inflated, that is capital I, constrictor, small I. C shape, round, wrinkle, capital R, small r. Pod color, green, yellow, capital R, capital G, capital small y. Seed color, yellow, green, capital Y, small g. Now we come to the inheritance of one gene, that is the monohybrid cross. A cross involving two parents, offspring of one character pair. Example, Mendel crossed tall and dwarf pea plants to study the inheritance of one gene. Okay, let us see an example. Parent, that is TT, that is the homozygous dominant, that is tall, and small t, 2T, homozygous recessive dwarf. We take one gamete, that is capital T and small t together, that is the heterozygous tall. Now the selfing gametes, that is F2, that is the second filial, when we do crossing between them, we get three tall plants and one dwarf. Let us look into their ratios. Monohybrid phenotypic ratio, tall, that is 3, dwarf 1, that is 3:1. Monohybrid genotypic ratio, homozygous tall, that is 1, heterozygous tall, that is 2, homozygous dwarf, that is 1:2:1. Now let's come to the test cross. Crossing an F1 hybrid with its recessive parent, it is used to find out the unknown genotype. Homozygous recessive, that is small t, homozygous recessive, that is small t. Now let us do the crossing and we get result, all plants are tall, whereas we get here the dominant genotype, half plants are tall while half plants are dwarf. Let us look into the representation, that is unknown flowers, that is heterozygous dominant, that is homozygous tall, unknown flower heterozygous. Mendel made similar observations for the other pairs of traits. Based on these, Mendel proposed that something was inherited from parents to offspring. He called them as factors. Factors are now called as genes. The F1, that is the TT, are when self-pollinated produces gametes T and capital T and small t in equal proportion. During fertilization, pollen grains of T have 50% chance to pollinate the eggs of the capital T and small t. Also, pollen grains of genotype T have 50% of chance of pollinate eggs of genotype capital T and small t. Now we come to the back cross and test cross. Back cross, crossing of the F1 hybrid back with any of the parent. Test cross, crossing of F1 hybrid with its recessive plant. It is used to find out the unknown genotype. Mendel conducted test cross to determine the F2 genotype. Now let us look up into another example, which is based on the colors of the flowers. Homozygous recessive. Small, that is the back cross, we can see here small w, here is a small w, where one of the sides where they use small w, and here also the same, and all flowers are violet and half of the flowers are white and half flowers are violet. Unknown flowers is homozygous dominant, unknown flowers is heterozygous. Now we come to the Mendel's principles or laws of inheritance. The first law, that is the law of dominance. Characters are controlled by discrete units are called factors. Factors occurs in pairs. In a dissimilar pair of factors, one member of the pair dominates the other recessive. Then the second, we have the law of segregation. During gamete formation, the factor alleles of a character pair present in parents aggregate from each other such that a gamete receives only one of the two factor. Homozygous parent production similar gametes. Heterozygous parent produces two kinds of gametes of each having one allele with equal proportion. Here we come to the third law, that is the Mendel's law of independent assortment. When two or more one pair of characters are involved in a cross factor, pairs are independently segregated from the other pair of character. Now let us see, why did Mendel's work remain unrecognized? Communication was not easy and his work could not be widely publicized. The concept of genes factors as the stable and discrete units was not accepted, that is, Mendel could not explain the continuous variation seen in nature. Mendel's mathematical approach was totally new and unacceptable. Mendel could not provide any physical proof for the existence of factors. In 1900, De Vries, Correns and von Tesmack independently rediscovered Mendel's results. Thank you.